Hi. Today I will try and pick this little 30 mm Burg Victor Magno, and I think it's made for a Danish locksmith because right here on Danish it says Danish Locksmith Association. So that's at least what I think. And the bidding is like this. And in the top at least it's pretty paracentric, so I cannot use my usual picks. I need to use this shot hook in 15 thousandths of an inch. So let's try and pick this one. And I have tried, I can not shim it and I can not bypass it. And I can only fit this short hook in there. So let us try. All right. Oh wait, let's just zoom a little bit in. That should be it. All right. Let us see pin one. False set. Pin two. Still a false set. Pin three. Come on. Nope. Try again. No. Four. If I could get under it. Nope. All right. Pin one. Pin two. Nope. It was this one. Ah, there we go. Let me just try this once more. Pin one. Pin two. Pin three, pin four, pin one again. This, come on, I'm not used to these fin picks. Ah, false set, pin two, pin three, come on, there, four, and it's open. So that's apparently pretty easy anyways if you have thin enough picks. But it's a nice little Burg Victor. I really do like those with especially with security pins and a paracentric keyway. Oh man. All right. What else can we do? Oh, I can actually take this car lock right here. And we can try and take that. It should be an easy one. So let's try. That should be enough. And some rakes and a hook for that purpose. That would be nice. All right, there. Okay. All right, I use this rake. I don't know what it's called, but I like this to car locks. All right, that's so easy. I actually had a car with a just as easy lock once. All right, I have 17 different auto jigglers. I have the, let me just get these spread out. I have the normal 10 auto jigglers, and I also have these seven others if you haven't seen those before. Oops. And I am great at throwing them around. So let's try them. I don't know what works for this lock, so let's find out. That one did. But again, it is an easy lock to open. And this one. Apparently most of these works at this. Ah, this one did not. That worked. Let's try this one. That worked too. So far only one didn't work. And that one. That did also work. And the last one of these seven. That didn't work either. So only five out of these seven works. That's pretty good for those. And the 10 normal ones, that worked very fast. But it is also my favorite tickler. Let's try the others. This doesn't... Yeah, well, we can just as well try. It will not surprise me if it works. That's such an easy lock. And there we go. And, well, I think all of these works in this lock. There we go. This one. And this one. So far, all of these 10 have worked. It's not often I can make this one work. And there we go. Okay, only a few more. This log is just too easy, but still. Last one. All of these 10 can do it. And 5 out of these 7 can. Oops. Alright. One last thing. Shall we try and SPP this one? And there we go. And come on. Yeah. I usually use this one if you haven't seen it before. It's just a Chinese pick, but it have a small ditch right here in the top here on the hook. So it's easy to find those wafers. That's why I love using this one. So let us try. I have to hold it with my thumb so it doesn't go down. I'm not used to SPPing these because they are so easy to rig open. So this is what takes me longest time, as you also can see. Yeah, but it usually works. I just have to find the wafer that is binding. So I'm just trying to go over it like this and. Come on. Apparently I cannot find it. I think I overset something. But SPPing is not working for me as well on these cards. Usually I cannot SPP them. So, well, it's a nice pick. And sometimes it does work, so that was a failure. But it was easy to open with rigs and jigglers and so on. So yeah, that's all I have for you today, guys. So thanks for watching and have a good day.